Dear students, welcome back to our English class. We were dealing with the fourth unit in which the third lesson, The Last Leaf, written by O. Henry. In our last class, we got a clear picture about the author William Sidney Porter, who was also known as O. Henry. Then we went through the summary of the story, The Last Leaf, written by William Sidney Porter. The story opens with a description of the winding street of Greenwich Village, New York City, where artists flock to find low-cost apartment with north-facing windows and Dutch-style gables. After they met at the restaurant, Sue and John C., the story's protagonists discover they have similar taste in art, food, fashion, etc. In May, they get a studio apartment together in Greenwich Village. In the month of November, John C. was struck by pneumonia. She remained in bed and would look out of the window. Now, let's see the summary of the next part. Sue was worried about John C. and called the doctor. The doctor visited them daily, but there was no improvement in John C.'s health. The doctor secretly asked Sue if something was the matter with John C. Sue replied that there was nothing to worry and asked why did the doctor think so. The doctor said that it seemed that John C. had decided not to live and did not want to recover from the illness. In such a case, medicines would not work on her. Sue sat beside her and started painting in order to create interest in her and take her mind off her illness. Sue would whistle at times to brighten up John C. Sue heard that John C. was speaking softly. John C. was making a backward counting while looking out of the window. Sue was curious and looked outside. She saw an ivy creeper plant beside the window of the room. As strong winds were blowing, the leaves of the creepers were falling. John C.'s eyes were opened wide. She was looking out of the window and counting 12, 11, 10, 9, then 8, 7, almost together. Sue was sad and surprised to see John C. counting like this. John C. said that before 3 days there was almost 100, but now it's only 5 left. And from John C., Sue understood that she believed that when the last one falls, she will die. Sue replied that this is pure foolishness. It's really silly. This morning, the doctor said her that her chance of getting well soon was excellent. Sue asked her to have some soup and she told her that she wanted to make money to buy some good port wine for John C. But John C.'s reply was she didn't want any more wine. She fixed her eyes out of the window and said, "There goes the other." It became 4. And she believed that she wants to see the last one fall. It gets dark. And she thinks that when the last leaf falls, she will too go. Now, let's have a model reading. One morning, the busy doctor invited Sue into the hall. She had one chance in, let us say, 10. He said as he shook down the mercury in her clinical thermometer. And that chance is for her to want to live. But your little lady has made up her mind that she is not going to get well. Has she anything on her mind? She wanted to paint the Bay of Naples someday, said Sue. No, something more important? A man, for instance. No. Well, it is a weakness then, said the doctor. But whenever my patients begin to count their last few moments, I subtract 50% from the curative power of medicine. If you can succeed in making her interested in something, in asking, for instance, about the latest style in women's clothes, then I will promise you a 1 in 5 chance for her instead of 1 in 10. After the doctor had gone, Sue went into her room and cried. Later, trying not to show her sadness, she went into John C.'s room whistling. John C. lay under the bedclothes with her face towards the window. Sue stopped whistling, thinking Jonesy was asleep. But soon Sue heard a low sound, several times repeated. She went quickly to the bedside. Jonesy's eyes were open wide. She was looking out of the window and counting backward. 12, she said, and a little later, 11, and then 10, and 9, and then 8, and 7, almost together. Sue looked out of the window. What are there to count? There was only a grey backyard and a blank wall of opposite house. An old ivy vine, dead at the root, climbed halfway up the wall. The cold breath of the autumn had blown almost all the leaves from the vine until its branches were almost bare. "What is it, dear?" asked Sue. 6, said Jonesy very quietly. "They are falling faster now. 3 days ago, they were almost 100. It makes my headache to count them, but now it's easy. There goes another one. There are only 5 left now." 5? What, dear?" "Tell me," said Sue. "Leaves on the ivy vine. When the last one falls, I must go too. I have known that for 3 days. Didn't the doctor tell you?" "The doctor didn't say any such things. That is pure foolishness," said Sue. "What have old ivy leaves to do with your getting well? And you used to love that old vine so much. Please don't be silly. The doctor told me this morning that your chance of getting well soon were excellent. Now try to take some soup and let me go back to work so that I can make money to buy you some good port wine." "You needn't get any more wine," said Jonesy, keeping her eyes fixed out of the window. "There goes another. That leaves just 4. I want to see the last one fall before it gets dark. Then I will go too." I hope you understood till here. So read the lesson up till here for 2 or 3 times. If there is any unfamiliar words, you can ask me. We will see the rest of the story in the next class. See you.